Hi, in this video I will show you how to develop or program a drag and drop event in WPF and Microsoft Desktop applications. First I show how this works. And here you see a small WPF application, and there I have some elements so at the bottom. So this is some button elements in my timesheet or shift table. So I go there, and as soon as I click with my mouse on it, I may see this drag icon, and then as soon as I leave the button from my mouse, then the object which is dragged will drop into a grid. And this works in the following way. And by the way, our code description is on our website, and the link will be below the video. First, we start in that point. We have here what we have seen there are WPF button elements in this case. So I said I have a button at in a data grid, and I drop this button into another one in another grid in a shift table. So for the event, the source event, source element has, I have to add there the preview mouse left button down event. And I said, okay, create a new button mouse event handler, which is called start track drop. So you are able to add this, this event at the XAML side. But in this case, we created the buttons at runtime. So we said, okay, where is it? It's a lot of code, as you see there. We said, okay, here is our button. We create the button at runtime. And we said, okay, this is a new button. And finally, we gave some text inside the button. And then we said, add a preview mouse left button down. So when I click on with the mouse on there, then you will see the track element. And we added the mouse button event handler start track event. So we jump on there, go to definition. And there we said, okay, create a button. So I'm tracking a button straight as an object, and then you need a data object, new data object, and inside this data object you may set all informations which are necessary for your drop. So all informations will be added in there. You may add the informations with set data, then you set a key value or key where the data is stored in. And in this case I'm adding a string, but you're also free to transmit a lot more information on there. And then you say drag drop, do drag drop, and then drag drop effect mouse move. And then inside there's the button, and there's the object, the information object. And at the receiver, when you drop something on there, you have to say to the element where you drop it. So this is in my case, a rectangle, or it's a border element. And there you have to say allow drop, and you have to say at the drop, create a new drag event handler. Target drop, that's what I called it in my case. So this is this. Now we have here the stuff where we start tracking, and then at the end or at the source, we say, okay, start border drop. And there is, we said, okay, this is a drop event. So it's track events, arcs are at here at the, all the information is in the E. And then we say, when you dropped in there, the argument, give me from the data the data which I have signed before. So this is get data color or name or ID, whatever is in the data object, which or track object. So this is like an array, and you may have all informations in string, integer, or any other stuff. And yeah, and take it from there. And then at the when I know where it where the target is, then I created a new button in there. And this new button is as a new child in the target. So, but you may do anything else. Now I told I've written all that code into onto my websites. You see there's a code description, drag drop, and then set the data, get the data at the drop event, and then there's the complete sample of what the drag drop does. And maybe English is sometimes terrible translated by Microsoft, but it's so maybe it should be better to use the Google Chrome, the Google translation, but at the moment it's like this. Yeah, and take this code from there, and if you have questions, then make a comment on there, and the link will be below the video.